What's up, everybody? My name is Rob Simmons, and as a request, I'll be reacting to another Mariah Carey compilation. This one will be called The Empress of Whistle Register, which obviously is going to betray her whistling skills throughout several performances, I guess. And it always is my requested reaction videos. I do take reaction requests, but as a rule, you have to be subscribed to my channel. Also, since my channel is at 2,000 subscribers, I'm celebrating by hosting a Q&A, so feel free to ask me any questions you want in the comments below, and once I have enough, I'll make a special video. But let's see what this video has in store. Right off the bat! We get our whistling skills. The highest part of the human voice. She shows why she has no equal with technical and mastery and unmatched musicality. Breath control. Obviously, I'm reading off the video. While many whistlers can sustain a single note, Mariah weaves through even the most complex vocal lines with ease, demonstrating her superior breath capacity. Oh, wow. Yeah, see? There it is. Her whistling skills. More recordings than actual video. Wow. It's amazing how well she can do that. Register transitions. Mariah's ability to seamlessly switch between registers is well known. She can go from head voice to whistle. Chest to whistle on a dime. Wow. Other whistlers can do both of these things. But only Mariah can fly through three registers on one breath. Let's listen. Chest to head to voice to whistle. Your favorite can never, I assume. Phonation and whistle voice. The ability to speak clearly in whistle voice is a sign of mastery. Yeah. Not everyone can do that. Mario's one of the most skilled vocalists in this area. Yeah, I agree, it really sets her apart from other artists. I'm only gonna talk during the subtitles, so you can really listen to it. It doesn't cease to amaze me. Mariah's vocal colors. Texture manipulation. I'm not a singer, so I don't really know a lot about or anything about these terms. One of Mariah's most fascinating skills is her ability to change her vocal texture to produce a variety of colors. She was one of only vocalists to manipulate the texture of her whistle voice notes. I wish that was a little louder. Pure thing. I can't imagine even trying to do that. Airy. I'm reading the text in case it's too small for you to read. Silky. Crystalline. That's a cool word. Dynamics. Unlike most other amateur whistlers, Mariah is capable of singing well notes at any volume she chooses. Pessimo? Whatever that means. Love that beat, mezzo fort. There's my dancing that I missed. Then last song. Fortissimo. Mariah's Mimi cry. She must have invented something. Mariah and her inspiration, Minnie Riperton, are unique in being able to imitate various sounds with their whistles. Also, she's not the only artist that can do that. Yeah, bird chirping. That sounds exactly like a bird chirping. Electric guitar. She sounded just like an electric guitar. A piccolo. Vocal cinema. It seems that all a singer has to do is hit a couple six-octave notes, and she's considered the next Mariah Carey. But the real article is if you able to sing in the whistle range for an extended period of time. There it is being demonstrated. Voice Renaissance. Mariah has a ring all the way up to the 7th octave, indicating great freedom and renaissance, hence why she's able to whistle so well. E6, F6, F number 6. Obviously those are random notes. Coloratura facility. People often mistakenly assume that everyone with a whistle register is a coloratura soprano. But Mariah is that rare breed that possesses the true coloratura ability within the whistle register. Whether it's soaring sky high, veering arpeggio, executing a descendant run with speed, accuracy, and beauty of tone, or doing two octave intervals with no effort. Yeah, I agree, she does make it pretty effortless. But the best example of her coloratura prowess is by far the use of her statio. She can use it in a variety of different ways, such as for musical decoration. Mesmalic vocalization. And she can take her statio into the upper reaches of the 7th octave. I think we're going to see a few different examples right here, in this case. But the true worth of her stacchio is in how fast and accurately she can execute it. If you know me, you know I can't resist to dancing. Example 2. Mariah's musicality. While her technical powers is amazing, even more incredible is her musical appellation of her whistles. She's the only whistle vocalist who uses her high notes to create musical effect at times. That fact alone puts her above every other whistler in the game. She uses her whistles to impress a variety of moods and feelings. I think that can be said for all areas of music, correct me if I'm wrong. The C7 in the background is used here to help create an atmosphere of awe and majesty around the song's message. In this clip, Mariah uses her whistle to enhance the imagery and flight of freedom. And I Wish You Well, Mariah's high notes are for dramatic effect to show her exuberance and singing God's grace. I know I'm mispronouncing some of these terms, and for that I'm sorry. Mariah's phrasing and the scope of emotion is used for emotional expression, in this case, joy. Yeah, I do hear joy in that whistle. The A6 is sung as an exclamation for climactic effect, show protagonist in the height of desperation. Excuse me. The soft EB6 is placed at the end of the song to signify the happiness Mariah feels for a lover. Mariah uses her whistles to set up the vocal layers and show a heightened emotional state. So Her whistle phrasing in yours is used to emphasize the lyrics she's singing. Mariah Carey, reigning over the whistle register since 1990. Obviously the last one was thanks for watching. That was just amazing. Before I started to even react to Mariah Carey, I wasn't even aware she had that whistle ability. And I just wish there was more of a video to make it a little bit more interesting to watch a still image with text. And tell you what, if there are any videos of her demonstrating her whistle ability you want me to react to, let me know in the comments. I've been talking too much. I also think that was the very first reaction where I talked throughout the video, because otherwise I'm pretty quiet. So that's a good way to change it up.